Truly, this is a battle of inches.
If we are moving in the right direction, it matters not.
Numenor was an island in the Sundering Seas to the west, the greatest realm of men before it sank beneath the waves. Few survived that calamity, mostly pioneers keen to settle what we now call Middle-earth. We Gondorians have often sought inspiration in what we know of Numenor, and many a young soldier would come to touch the brow of this helmet, wondering what great battles in far-off lands its owner must have seen.
A helmet of Numenor. Adequate craftsmanship, given the materials available.
That is the closest you've come to respecting a fellow craftsman.
Gaugar Beak, yes. But not as scary as many say.
I just hear something?
This ore comes from a longboat that washed ashore in the Bay of Belphalus, and it surely passed through many a corsair's hands before finding its way inland, where I espied it atop a merchant's cart years ago. I've often wondered about the hands that rowed it to sea. Were they the calloused hands of a slave, or those of a dashing corsair of Umbar? I suppose I'll never know.
What use has an oar away from its boat, and so far from the sea?
To remind people that Middle-earth exists beyond the bounds of Mordor.
Why do we bother to capture Northmen alive? Ranger! Let's kill him!
Belas. The orcs respect strength, whether it comes from a Graug, a warchief, or a ring. Yet in Mordor, possessing strength also makes one a tempting target.
Thank you.
More important than possessing brute strength is the ability to wield it, even if it is not your own.
Fancy themselves to be tamers of beasts.
Their beasts won't stop us from taking their fortress.
Yeah!
They only have their beasts now.
That won't be enough to stop me.
Now kill him! Do you believe you can escape your fate? Believe!
Captain soon. Thanks for that.
This is truly a cursed place.
For now, but we will bring light back to Mordor.
Understand why Dark Lord doesn't just smite the creepy beggar.
shot. I see the Ranger! I ate a weird mushroom the other day.
The top! There, Aragorn!
You take your leg off!
Really gonna sink a quill in you now!
Ugly beast to kill. And what's that you're riding on?
Grook.
There you go! That must have hurt! Prepare yourself for death!
Disarm him!
The old gods abandoned us and the music of the world was thrown into disarray. He saw it as his mission to set it right. One Dark Lord correcting the mistakes of another. The future is filled with them. Each one determined to save the world from itself. To purge the chaos. To rule all.
After Morgoth came Sauron, and after Sauron...
After Sauron will come peace.
here for ya! That's how we
Those bookshelves cannot compare to the great libraries of Minas Tirith, but they're still the biggest collection of knowledge for miles in any direction. As a girl, I thrilled at the wisdom gathered here. Everything from histories to poetry to cookbooks from a bygone age. This one, Tales of Farthest Umbar, was a childhood favorite. Stories of daring from pirates of old. Real corsairs are far less noble than these tales make them out to be, I'm sure. They can't be as cruel as the orcs.
When I became a ranger, I thought I'd see the entire world.
It's much the same everywhere. The ambitious striving against the dull.
Enough!
Yeah.
are just so tough. And none of it will matter because you're just so slow.
Ugo.
Brother Tark, I'm gonna make on you. And then, I'm gonna get creative!
Glook.
From me. Now, I'll take something beautiful from you.
Once we kill or conquer all the humans in Mordor, then Gondor, then all the elves, and the dwarves, and the hobbits, who have we got left to fight?